You know what? I think this little guy's tail would fit in the gap. This idea is so stupid that it might just work. Here goes. It fits perfectly. Oh shit, the tail's just snapped off. Well, this was one of my better ideas, wasn't it? Fuck's sake. Oh. I'm not closing it again after all that. Right, let's see what we have here. Photo of me and Gavin. It's broken. I put it here out of the way. And here are the DVDs. Don't really care what I watch, I'll just stick some crappy horror on. Huh? Shit, fell asleep. Huh. Gone 8. Phone's ringing. Hello? Gavin? Oh, Rob, hi. What's up? Oh, really? That's brilliant. Oh, thanks so much. Thank you. That was Rob, my neighbor from the apartment down the hall. He has my package. The delivery man signed it and left it with him. He's bringing it over now. I'm just... Shit. I'm doing this. I have to get ready. Shit. Yes. What now, Rob? Forgotten where I live? Hello? Yes? This is Alex Davenport speaking. I... Thank you. I can't breathe. I can't fucking breathe.
Hey, Alex. Jesus, how bad is this storm? Oh, hey, are you all right?
I'm fine. Thanks. Fine. I just had a bit of bad news. I'll be fine. Sorry, Rob.
Ah, God. Gavin again?
Nah, nothing to do with him this time. Sorry. It'll be all right. I just need to sort some stuff out. Bad times. You know how it is. Hey, look, thanks for bringing this over.
You sure?
No, yeah, seriously, I'll be fine. Thanks, Robert.
You only call me Robert when you're not okay, Al. I know you like your own company, but seriously, you know where I am if you need me.
Yeah, I do. And honestly, tomorrow you're gonna have me sniveling on your doorstep begging you to listen, but right now I just need...
It's okay, Al. Take all the time you want.
Wait, I won't be here tomorrow. Sorry, Rob, I'll call you. Please don't worry about me. I don't want to think about anything right now. The days are endless. I need to get ready to leave. There's always tomorrow. I'll call Mom tomorrow, too. Outside, the city begins to withdraw. A siren sounds in the night, blue light reflecting on brickwork as tireless paramedics rush to the scene of another trauma. On the pavement below, a woman hurries home, casting furtive glances over her shoulder as she pulls her coat tight around herself, the rain beating patterns on the fabric. A car drives past, music disturbing the peace. The woman looks at the man in the car. He turns the music down, calls something out as he passes. I see the woman start to walk faster. She flinches at the thunder. The car drives off. Another set of sirens now. Somewhere in the distance, the city is drowning. This is where we live. This is our world. Ebb and flow, endless, forever. It's the perfect time for loneliness. The perfect time to indulge the selfish, petulant monologues of the dispossessed. But sometimes it's just like this, you know? Sometimes we can't help it. Sometimes we don't want to go out and hang out with your friends. Sometimes we don't want to talk. Sometimes we just want to wallow. You don't know me. You never fucking knew me. Go fuck yourself, you judgmental, self-righteous prick. Cat, I'll see you soon. Looks like the storm didn't reach here. The snow's still falling. It's a clean, crisp night. Just past midnight. The train should be here any moment. I'm not walking away. I'm here now. There's no turning back. I can't see the train. I hope it shows up soon. I'm freezing. An intellectual-looking guy. His jacket has elbow patches. Cool. Just gone midnight. Feels like I've been here forever. It's a bit too big to carry around. So, hey, you been waiting long?
I'm not sure. I lost track of the time.
Tell me about it. I nearly slept through tonight. There's a clock over there, though.
It hasn't moved since I got here.
Oh. Great.
So, where are you headed?
A little port town. Last stop.
Me too. I'm not staying there, though. Catching the ferry to
Augur Peak Island. Yeah, me too.
It's not a common destination, is it? What brings you to the island, if you don't mind me asking?
It's dumb. You'll laugh.
I'm headed there to dig around in the dirt and check out broken pots. Trust me, I won't laugh.
Okay, fine. It's a bit of a personal pilgrimage.
Ah, I won't pry any further. But, you know the funny thing?
What's that?
It feels that way to me, too.
Train should be here soon. I think I can see it.
It's going to be a long, boring journey. Fool that I am, I forgot to bring any recreational reading material. All I have to pore over are some historical texts. Thrilling.
I guess I should let go of it. I won't need it after tomorrow. Just one final reminder of Gavin I can do without. Hey.
Hey.
You can take this. I've already read it.
Pulp horror fiction?
Yeah, sorry.
No. Not at all. It's my guilty pleasure.
Mine too. This one's great. You ever heard of Cassell?
I can't say I have.
Oh, well, he...
Looks like this is us.
Two passengers. Well, this is my lucky day. It's freezing out here. You guys got on board old Gloria now. She's nice and warm. I'll come on and show you to your cabins momentarily. I'll just grab your luggage. Off you go now. Well, well. What's this then? Who's our cute little doggy? I know just who'll like this. Settle down, you. We're nearly ready. And if you start causing a scene now, I'll have to tell young Floyd what you've been up to. And we both know what'll happen then. That's it. There's a good boy. You just be a good wee writer and wait, watch and listen like you always do. It'll be over soon and you'll be back home before you know it. Aye, I reckon so.
Wicked shall hold their tongues. They stir beneath this silent world of saints and sinners, twixt the living and the dead. Train's still going. Can't have slept long. We left. When did we leave? Where did we leave? God damn. It's unnervingly quiet. Maybe I should fetch some water. The restaurant should be open now. What do we have here, then? Wallet. Yes. Dr. Lang, curator of the Crenicon Thames Museum. That's me, all right. It's nothing interesting. The Charnel House Burial by Louis Cassel. To think I don't get enough of the dead without pulp horror novels. Just one vice. I don't want to be carting a book around unnecessarily. I can't just cart around any old thing. It's nothing interesting. Let's go stir up a drink or two. Maybe something strong is in order. Clear the head. Okay, I'm Dr. Harold Lang. My destination is Augur Peak Island. I'm on this train to... I'm going to evaluate some finds. They called me to... A painting of an old train. I don't think the ticket inspector would be too happy with me if I took it. A painting of a train. Is it this one? No. Looks too old. Maybe an ancestor. Good evening, my friend. I was wondering if you could...
Ah, yes. I've seen you poking around. Having trouble settling down, are we?
Something like that. Could do with a stiff drink about now?
Right you are, then.
That painting on the wall...
Isn't she a beaut? Runs like clockwork, so she does.
It's this train. Isn't it a little old?
You kids today have got no appreciation of machinery.
We've got to be the same age at best.
Well, practically grew up in us, so I did. There's nothing about Old Gloria that I don't know.
Locked. I can't just... It's nothing. Locked? Isn't this the way out?
Right you are, then.
The door to the next carriage appears to be locked. Is that normal? Nothing's wrong, is it?
You city folks always jump to conclusions. There's nothing wrong. It's just how we do things when our guests are asleep. It prevents prying eyes and swift fingers.
Isn't that a bit of a fire hazard?
Pal, let me tell you. If a fire breaks out in this train, then no amount of carriage doors are going to save you from roasting. If you catch my drift. Be a steel coffin if the unthinkable happened.
Sheesh. Could you possibly unlock the door? I could really use a drink.
Don't reckon I can, no. Can give you the key, though. On one condition.
Please don't tell me he's gonna ask me to solve some ridiculous conundrum of his.
Bring me back a shot of whiskey when you get back. Old Floyd will hook you up. Just tell him it's for Don.
Whew. No problem, my friend. Thank you. Dr. Harold Lang, Krennic on Thames Museum, badge ID CCPN1318. Ah, a bit of money. Just what the doctor ordered. A crisp £5 note. It's my credit card. Aha! Open! A solemn-looking young woman. She's a little unnerving. It's bad enough looking at the picture, let alone carrying it around. Ah, better... Ah. Locked. Ah. No good. I can't even get the key. The restaurant is locked. This key's no good.
Ah. Floyd must be getting things ready. Just take your time, boy. Let him do his thing. He'll unlock it when he's good and ready. There's no rush, is there?
This isn't mine. I probably shouldn't even touch it. Grabbing other people's luggage is a bit of a faux pas. A huge black holdall. Looks very heavy. God knows what's inside. A beautifully polished wooden box. It has a red, teardrop-shaped gem set into the top. He doesn't look very well. That's if it's even a he. He looks positively sick, in fact. Hello there. I'm sorry for the intrusion. I was just what? He's muttering something. I can't make it out. I'm sorry? What was that? Maybe I should be going. I'm sorry to have bothered you. He doesn't seem to be able to open his mouth properly. I think I'd better leave. Maybe I should mention this to that ticket inspector. There's a man in one of the rooms in the next carriage. I don't think he's at all well.
We get some right crazies on the train sometimes, I'm telling you. You learn to leave them be after a while.
The wretched man can barely speak.
Aye. And I'd be the same way after the amount of booze most of these boys have had. Is Floyd still not operating then?
Not as far as I'm aware.
Ah, well, give the boy time. Hey, saw one of your fellow passengers pop their head at the room at the end of the corridor. Maybe you'd get a better conversation out of her. Pretty little thing, so she was.
Thanks. Are you sure that she was... Well, this was the right room. Hello? Something doesn't feel right about this. They're all the same. Why would everyone have the same luggage? I want to have a look inside, but these are somebody's bags. As a child, I used to make origami like this. Where's the girl that ticket collector claims to have seen? I'm sure she won't miss just one. Could she be... Nothing. But that sounded awfully like a door unlocking in the next carriage. Is Floyd ready for business? I don't... Locked. Shuttered and sealed, just like in my room. Food's getting cold. I haven't heard any sort of dinner bell. Are we supposed to just know when it's dinner time? Are any of these places for me, I wonder? Good evening. Floyd, is it?
Ah, Mr. Lang, how nice of you to join us.
It's Dr. Lang, actually. But who needs formalities in a place like this?
Quite. I suppose you're here on business?
Business?
A drink, Mr. Lang, that is what you're after, is it not?
Perhaps a bite to eat first?
Unfortunately, all our meals are reserved. By all means, have a drink, though. Pull up a stool.
I'd better not stay. Your ticket collector, Don, I think it was, has tasked me with procuring him a glass of whiskey.
Ah, yes, he did leave his hip flask here, thinking about it. It's right there on the bar. This one's on the house, Mr. Lang.
It's empty. I don't think so. Flask's empty, Floyd. Better give me a shot of whiskey.
No more freebies, I'm afraid, Mr. Lang. That'll be £5.
£5? You're burying me alive here. Here you go, my good man. Better hit me with another.
Excess is the path to ruin, Mr. Lang. We wouldn't want you to go before your time, would we?
I think I can manage just one more drink.
That's what they all say, isn't it, Mr. Lang? Just one more for the road? I can handle it. Never had difficulty driving before. And what about your liver, Mr. Lang? Can that handle just one more drink?
Goddamn, Floyd, you always were a preachy son of a bitch, weren't you?
I think you're quite mistaken, Mr. Lang. We've never met, you and I. I just don't want you to do yourself an injury.
I can handle one more goddamn drink, you stupid bitch. Just stay out of my way, and I'll stay out of yours.
That's right, Mr. Lang. Let it all out. There's a good little puppy.
What the hell? What did... Shit. I need to go, Floyd. It's been a pleasure, as always.
Aren't you forgetting your promise, Mr. Lang? Whiskey. For Dawn.
Once more unto the breach, dear friends.
I'm afraid you can't just take it, Mr. Lang, no matter how much you wish to.
How much?
It's not cheap, I'm afraid. 40 pounds should do it.
I don't have that much money on me.
I'm sure you'll find a way, Mr. Lang. You always do.
Okay, here goes. Goodbye, bank balance.
If you just enter your PIN.
Now, what was my PIN? I remember setting a... Dr. Harold Lang.
All done.
Thank you, Floyd.
No, thank you, Mr. Lang.
Food's getting cold. What the hell is happening to me? Oh, my head. I can't think.
Oh, Mr. Lang, that pale man you met. I think he just wants a best friend. Perhaps you're not quite what he's looking for? You are, after all, blind drunk.
You're lonely. Is that it?
Nah.
I think Floyd was right. He doesn't seem to be warming to me, though. Locked. I don't... Locked. Worth a try, I suppose. Hey, sir, this isn't quite man's best friend, but... That seems to have done the trick. I think he wants me to open it. There's an engraving here. He whose blood the earth's dark thirst doth quench ascends unto the heavens from her womb. Interesting. Locked. It's firmly attached. But, hey, I think I can move it. It's open. Oh! The box is filled with earth and worms. They're everywhere. Why would he lock something like this away? He's playing with the dog.
Boy, you really came through for an old man.
Talk about dramatizing it. You can't be any older than 35. Glad to make the night pass by just that little bit easier. That reminds me, I never did find that girl in this carriage.
Girl? What are you talking about? There's no girl on this train.
But you said...
No. It's not nice to go messing with old Don's head just because he's had a sniff of whiskey. You know, I'll let you, Lang. You've got spirit.
Well, thanks. But that girl, you honestly told me you saw her.
I reckon I didn't. And you know what? It's the craziest damn thing. You're just about the only soul I've seen on this train tonight. It's not normally like that. Even Floyd's usually around. Must be his night off.
Floyd is around. I got the whiskey from him, remember? And what about the sick passenger in the next car?
Not seen anyone around, son. You know what I need on a night like this? A good book. Can't beat a good novel and a drink.
A good book, eh? Have you ever read the works of Louis Cassel?
Can't say I've heard of him.
He's a horror writer. In fact, he lives on Augur Peak Island.
Augur Peak Island? Never heard of it.
Isn't that where we're going? Well, I have one of his novels somewhere.
Now that will be just the ticket. Get it?
Hope Don likes it as much as I did. And... well, why not? The key to 2A. Maybe I'll find this mysterious girl. Huh. Guess he won't be wanting the novel after all. Best leave him be. If I shut off the lamp, then the room will be pitch black, and I shouldn't have any need for it outside this room. More photos of that girl from the picture in the corridor. She's sitting in different seats around a house. What is it about these pictures? More photos of that girl from the picture in the corridor. My... not re- my God! They're Victorian death pictures! I want to have a look inside, but this is somebody's bag. Another large... a solemn... I don't want to. I don't want to see. Oh, God, get me out of this place. What have I done? Destroyed. All destroyed. I can't even smell the booze. It's like this happened years ago. What the hell could have done this? There's a bag. Oh, God. It's slumped against the door. Floyd? Don? My God. I can't do it's moving. It's twitching. Please, God, don't make me look. This can't be here for no reason. There's a thin crack around the base of the train, as if it opens. I can't get my nails in the gap. Not... there. It came upon. There's some kind of thin key inside. There. The panel is open. There's a switch marked shutters. The train's picking up speed. I'll just slide it open. No. No. Dear God.
What is this? Earth. Nothing but earth pressed tight against the window. This can't have just happened. This can't be happening. I can't breathe. There's no air. Katerina, please.